Hello friends, let us now learn about the viruses and cancers. So we have two types of viruses causing cancers. One we have RNA virus, then we have DNA virus. In the RNA virus, human T cell lymphoplasty, T cell leukemia or lymphoma can result in cancer. Human T cell lymphoma virus will result in adult T cell lymphoma or leukemia, whereas hepatitis C virus will result in hepatocellular carcinoma, whereas DNA viruses will result in human papilloma virus, will result in cervical carcinoma, whereas Epstein-Barr virus will result in many carcinomas. Hepatitis B virus results in hepatocellular carcinoma. Then we have Merkel cell polyoma virus. This will result in Merkel cell carcinoma. Then we have Kaposi sarcoma. Herpes virus will result in Kaposi sarcoma. Kaposi sarcoma, herpes virus will result in Kaposi sarcoma. We will learn some important points about human T cell leukemia or lymphoma virus. If you see human T cell leukemia lymphoma virus, this causes adult T cell leukemia or lymphoma. This will exhibit tropism. This will also exhibit tropism for CD4 cells. This is transmitted via sexual intercourse, blood products. This is transmitted via sexual intercourse, blood products, and breastfeeding. It develops in, leukemia develops in around 3 to 5% of individuals, and it lasts for 40 to 60 years of latent period. What is the most common cause of death? That is, opportunistic infections are the most common cause of death. Now, why are there opportunistic infections? This is because of the neoplastic. Here there will be neoplastic expansion of T regulatory cells, which will result in opportunistic infections. Then if you see HTLV-1 viral, one gene will code for viral protein, which is TAX, which will activate the pro-growth and pro-survival signaling pathways. They will activate the pro-growth and pro-survival signaling pathways, which include the PI3K or AKT, NF, Kappa B is activated because of this virus. Okay, now let us learn about the next virus, which is human papilloma virus. Okay, human papilloma virus will have two things. One, it has E6. Second, we have E7. E6 will inhibit P53, whereas E7 will inhibit retinoblastoma. So what happens? Now E6 will inhibit P53, and E6 will also increase the TERT expression, which increases the telomerase expression. Okay, E7 will inhibit retinoblastoma, and it will also inhibit P53. So this P21, it also inhibits P21. Because of the inhibition of P21, it increases CDK4 cyclin D pathway. So overall, there will be increased cell proliferation. Okay, then this is about Epstein-Barr virus. Now let us learn some important points about HPV virus. Now let us learn some important points about Epstein-Barr virus. Epstein-Barr virus will result in Burkitt's lymphoma. Okay, it will result in B cell lymphoma. In immunosuppressed, it will result in B cell lymphoma. In immunosuppressed individuals, it will result in a set of Hodgkin's lymphoma. And it will result in nasopharyngeal carcinoma, gastric carcinoma, T cell lymphoma, and natural killer cell lymphoma. It also results in T cell lymphoma or natural killer cell lymphoma. This is the most common associated with Epstein-Barr virus among all of these. Okay, Epstein-Barr virus. How does Epstein-Barr virus act? Now, Epstein-Barr virus will first attaches to CD21 receptor, which is present on B cells, and then it infects the B cells and also the epithelial cells of oropharynx. Now here infection is latent and there is no viral replication. Infection is latent and there is no viral replication and the cells are not killed. And this will result in expression of viral proteins leading to cancer. Okay, so these are the important points about Epstein-Barr virus. Now we will see about the next virus, which is human herpes virus 8. Okay, human herpes virus 8 is actually a gamma herpes virus and it is associated with Kaposi sarcoma. This is associated with Kaposi sarcoma, multicentric Castleman disease, and it is also associated with primary effusion lymphoma. This HHV8 genome will expresses the genes which will inhibit apoptosis, and causes cell cycle entry and causes angiogenesis, resulting in tumors. Then we will see some important points about the Castleman disease. Okay, Castleman disease. Okay, now Castleman disease. There is also one more name for Castleman disease. It is also called as angiofollicular lymph node hyperplasia. It is also called as angiofollicular lymph node hyperplasia. The etiology of this Castleman disease, it is caused by HHV8 associated multicentric Castleman disease. There is one type which is HHV8 associated multicentric Castleman disease and unicentric Castleman disease, and we have HHV8 negative or idiopathic Castleman disease. In both these diseases, if you see, there is increased interleukin-6. Okay, now we should see that there are three different histological types of Castleman disease. There are three different histological types of Castleman disease. Three different histological types of Castleman disease include: one, we have hypervascular Then we have plasma cell type. This hypervascular is unicentric. Okay, plasma cell type is uni or multicentric, whereas mixed variant is present, which is again multicentric. Okay, this first we will see plasma cell type. Plasma cell type, it shows hypertrophic germinal centers. It shows hypertrophic germinal centers and it shows increased vascularity. Whereas multicentric variant has both hypervascularity and it has and plasma cells type. Now what is seen in hypervascularity, I'll add in next page. Okay, in this hypervascularity type of Castleman disease, you will see there will be small regressed or atrophic germinal center. There will be small regressed atrophic germinal centers are present with onion appearance. Sorry, onion skin appearance of mantle zones. There is onion skin appearance of mantle zones around germinal centers, and there is also lollipop appearance. There is also lollipop appearance is present, and you will see that the blood vessels radially penetrated. The blood vessels radially penetrate the atrophic germinal centers. So onion skin appearance, lollipop appearance, blood vessels radial penetration is seen in hypervascular type. So if you see the clinical features include, here the patient will suffer from multiple enlarged lymph node regions with night sweats, weight loss, weakness will be present, and you will also see fatigue. Okay, here you will also see presence of hepatosplenomegaly. Okay, the clinical treatment of this is presence of interleukin 6 inhibitors should be given, like siltuximab and tocilizumab. Okay, these are the important points about Castleman disease. Thank you for watching.